Maestro, a venue that sold out in less than a week. The World Arena when tickets went on sale, and for you fans all across the country, realizing that Nitro is coming to your hometown, to your area, you are not going to want to be left out. As Chris Jericho comes in, let me announce these two on sale dates. This coming Friday, April 24th, the first ever Nitro at the MCI Center in Washington, D.C. Tickets will go on sale for that event. The date for that event is Monday, June 1st. Tickets go on sale this Friday at the MCI Center box office and Ticketmaster. And Mean Gene and the Nitro Girls will be at the MCI Center main lobby Friday from 10 a.m. to noon when tickets go on sale. And we have another announcement. This Friday, tickets go on sale for Nitro coming to Denver and the Coliseum on Monday, August 3rd. Tickets at all Ticketmaster outlets, and the Nitro Girls will be at Rite Aid on South Colorado Boulevard Friday from noon to 2 p.m. Now, what's this about?
I know you're digging the mahi-mahi. You know, I've erected this shrine to Dean Malenko because I respect this man more than any other. And I have an update on the status of Dean's career, and it's a good news, bad news situation. The bad news is Dean has definitely retired from pro wrestling. What? He will never, ever step into the ring again. But the good news is, he's got a job interview at Harry's Burgers in Tampa, Florida tomorrow. And as soon as he finds out if he's got the job, I'll let you guys know. So, Dean, this one's for you, little trooper. Thank you!
Now, we don't believe that, and you fans obviously don't believe it as well.
But the man with the trophies has a new addition to his collection.
Yeah, he's got the
dress.
The dress, the
ring entrance garb.
The attire of Prince Iaukea. Last night, Jericho retained, as you can clearly see, the cruiserweight belt. And, of course, another trophy to his collection, the mask of Juventud Guerrero. Juventud, former cruiserweight champ, and Juventud has become quite a mega star since losing his mask, guys.
Isn't that amazing? One of the few. And Juventud has quite an opportunity to regain the cruiserweight title tonight.
Hey, Jericho! It's hard to cut him off with the pants! Juve moved!
And slapped him in the face for good measure as well. Up on top, Juventud lands on the... Oh, look at that! Grabbed him by the hair to take him down, and the fans love this one. Up on top!
Oh, my! What a Frankensteiner that was!
Now Jericho just running for his life here, and Juventud is relentless.
Look, the Jerkaholic got his leg caught in the rope. Juve caught him.
Juventud snap-married him over. Now Juventud will drive in the rear chin lock here. Wow. Absolutely breathless action here. Breathtaking action, and we are heading now to Goldberg and Raven for the United States Heavyweight Championship, and Hollywood Hogan and the world champ Macho Man for the world title all here tonight live. Up is Juventud. That's a great move by Jericho.
Yeah, Jericho's got talent. He's good. He just can't control his emotions, yet he's too young to walk that fine line between being confident and being over cocky, and that's the curse that Jericho's living under.
Jericho measures him for a forearm shot underneath the chin. Jericho once again. Back shot. Here he goes. Juventud. Seems to me Juventud, of course, never surrender to his motto. But it seems to me that you get Juventud down, you get him to the brink of where he thinks he will never be able to continue, and he fires back on each and every time.
Well, he definitely has that never say die attitude. No question. Talk about well scouted out. He was planning for that one. He was preparing for Jericho. Dropped down, and Jericho did not connect. Now here goes Juventud.
Over the top.
Put him right in the head.
Somersault over the top rope. Both men hitting very, very hard that time. Guerrero has fired up, more fired up than really than we've ever seen him. Really prepared for this one. Up on the top rope. Had a new cruiserweight champ. Here comes Juventud again. Juventud caught by Jericho.
Oh, can he pull out that DDT? Cover.
One, two, and still didn't get him.
That wasn't three?
No, there was not. And Charles Robinson was right on top of it.
Two and a half. Juve was just not over the the shoulders enough. He was more over the midsection. Not enough weight on top of the chest.
Standing switch and a nice one, but a pair of elbows by Hubertud staggered him, and now over the top, Hubertud lands on his feet. Guerrero so agile, so quick. Hops up. He got caught by Jericho in the clutches now of the Lion Tamer.
Sitting down more. That's got to hurt.
But he never surrenders. He hasn't tapped out yet.
He's going to pass out. But he can squirm out of that.
Hubertud is still not giving up.
Look at his neck.
He's saying no.
Look at how his neck is bent.
Incredibly, Hubertud still, he's shaking his head no. He's not giving up at all.
But can he maintain consciousness?
That's the question. Will he go out?
In a position like that, consciousness won't last long. He may be wiggling out of here.
God, there's the hand. It's moving, so Guerrero's still in it. This is an incredible turn of events here. In the clutches of the Lion, it's finally over.
I never saw him tap out.
No, he didn't.
He's out cold.
Yes, I think it's a good call by the official, Charles Robinson.
Yeah, when your neck's bent like that, it's just a matter of time. You can't get oxygen in. You can't get blood to the brain. You're going to go out.
Oh, my God, I killed Ruby.
Hubertud did not give up. He did not give up. He blacked out. He is out cold, but he did not give up. Still, the Cruiserweight champ is Chris Jericho. Ladies and gentlemen, coming up next, Goldberg and Raven for the U.S. title.